Hi, everybody. San Bonani. Goeiemôre. Dumela. For too long, for much too long now, we have used elections as a way of expressing racial identity and racial solidarity. This time, we must take the next step. We must make the issues the issue in this election. And the key issue in a local government election is achieving excellent service delivery for all. We must create conditions that attract investment and that bring jobs wherever we govern. This means we must have clean, corruption-free government. Panzi luhwabilizo panzi. Panzi luhwabilizo panzi. Because corruption chases away investors and corruption makes poor people even poorer. Councillors and officials must do the jobs they were elected or appointed to do. And that is why all DA councillors and all our mayors, and you've just seen our candidate, our mayoral candidate, the mayor-elect of Johannesburg, Musi Maimane, speaking to you today. And that's why all of our mayors are nominated according to their fitness for the purpose of doing the job. And that is why our councillors and mayors are given performance targets and are measured against them. There is no free ride in the Democratic Alliance. Every DA municipality will work very hard to eliminate the unnecessary bureaucracy, and there is still so much of it that stifles growth and destroys jobs. We will work to bridge the digital divide by giving more people access to the internet and speeding up internet connections. Internet access can be one of the greatest empowerment tools for the poor because it links people with opportunities across the country. Our indigent policy will ensure that people who qualify receive enough water and electricity for their families. And we will continue our focus on upgrading informal settlements with bulk infrastructure and with services. We will also provide free antiretroviral medication to HIV-positive pregnant mothers and to rape survivors at municipal health facilities. And DA municipalities will continue to use social amenities such as libraries and sports fields to provide young people with alternatives to antisocial behavior so that they don't have to become involved in gangs and drugs. In 2006, the DA inherited the worst-run metro in the country. Corruption was rife. The ANC administration spent only 60% of its capital budget. And the shambolic state of its revenue collection system meant that the municipality was owed 4 billion rand in unpaid rates and service charges. That's true. 4 billion rand it was owed. It was in the red. It was bankrupt. Within a year of taking office, the DA had cut debt by nearly 1 billion rand within a year. Sound financial management and revenue collection meant that there was more money for service delivery and infrastructure development. By 2010, The DA had increased Cape Town's revenue collection to 96% and had more than tripled its spending on infrastructure. These savings and efficiencies allowed the DA to double its spending, on free water, subsidized housing, and electricity for the poor. It also meant we could increase the number of poor people who qualified for subsidized services. And when the DA took over, it doubled the qualifying income threshold to 3,000 Rand per month, thus benefiting many, many more people. Those eligible receive a 100% rates rebate, free refuse collection, 10,000 litres of free water, and 50 kilowatt hours of free electricity every month. In every place that we apply our formula, no matter whether it is a town or a village or a city or a province, we get results. Just last week, the Department of Cooperative Governance and Traditional Affairs, that's COGTA, the National Department again of Minister Sicelo Shiqeka, named Bavians, which is the only DA-run municipality in the Eastern Cape, as the best for service delivery in that province. Halala Bavians! Halala Bavians! The DA-run Bavians in the Eastern Cape also won the award for best collector of revenue in that province. And last year, the UHABS index ranked the Western Cape municipalities, most of which are governed by the DA, as number one in the country for service delivery. When I visit towns where service delivery is failing, people often say to me, "Helen, please bring the DA here and fix things up." And I reply that we do stand for elections everywhere, but we can only fix things if we win and govern the municipality. And we can only win in the places where you live if enough people vote for us. Only you can control your future. Your vote is your power to do that. Because the truth is this: if you want a better life, you need to think about choosing a party that has proved it delivers for all wherever it governs. So give us a chance to prove it to you. Put us to the test. You have nothing to lose by trying something new in this local election. If you usually vote for the ANC in the national election, the local election is your chance to do something different. Use your freedom to choose. This election is about breaking free of the straitjacket that keeps people voting for the same party over and over again and somehow expecting a different result. So in a democracy, you can make the change and choose a party that will deliver a better future for all. So let's stop comparing the South Africa of today with the South Africa of the past. And let's start comparing the South Africa of today with the South Africa we all know we can become. One nation with one shared future. Isizwe sinye, igamva elinye. Inasi met intukoms. Sichaba basisiling. Bokamusobo libong. That is what we're saying. We are saying, if you live in a DA-governed municipality, you know exactly what kind of difference the DA can make. Sichaba silising. Bokomuse bulibong. One nation with one future. And if you don't live in a DA-governed municipality, now is your chance to make it happen. Now is the time. Mandisati. Kinako. Detectors, no. So whatever you do, make sure you vote on the 18th of May. And vote DA. Want to hear a little bit of a